Okay, welcome to the bandwagon once again. First of all, I want to wish you all a happy new year. I was over now, but I still wish you all a happy new year. I'm going to start it off neat with a little song called The Bottle's Finally Empty. I wanted all the answers, but I was much too drunk to have. You wouldn't know the questions if they were written in the glass. But now I'm finally sober. My life is better than before. The bottle's finally empty, but my cup keeps running over. The bottle's finally empty. I think I've won the battle, Lord. What could you do for this poor fool? Now my cup keeps running over. And friends who like the bottle full are empty in the end. You weren't around when I was down to take my shaky hand. But there were those who seemed to know what I was begging for. They took away my bottle. Now my cup keeps running over. The bottle's finally empty. I think I've won the battle, Lord. What could you do for this poor fool? Now my cup keeps running over. What could you do for this poor fool? Now my cup keeps running over. So Jim's gonna do a song for us now, a song called Don't Tell Me What To Do.
We've tried and we've tried, but it's over. Guess I didn't fit the image in your mind. You tell me to find another lover.
Don't tell.
There was a man that would do a song for us, and they'll call it the Black Velvet Band.
Ride ye shone like the diamond, I taught her the queen of the land, and her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with the black velvet band. In a neat little town ye call Belfast, in the trend of a trade I was found, and many a hour of sweet happiness I spent in this neat little town. Till a sad misfortune came o'er me, which caused me to stray from the land, far away from my friends and relations, betrayed by the black velvet band. Her eyes, they shone like the diamonds, I thought her the queen of the land, and her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with the black velvet. And as I was strolling down Broadway, not meaning too long for to stay, who should I see was a fair pretty maid a-walking along the highway. She was so dark and handsome, and her naked was just like a swan, and her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with the black velvet band. As I was courting the fair pretty maid, a gentleman passing me by, I knew it was the doing of it by the look in her roving black eyes. A gold watch he took from his pocket and placed it right into my hand. I said, this is the last of it for me and the black velvet band. Her eyes, they shone like the diamonds, I thought her the queen of the land, and her hair hung over her shoulder, tied back with the black velvet band. Before the judge and the jury, next morning I had to appear. The judge, he said to me, young man, your case is forever clear. He gave me 7 years of hard labor to be spent far away from this land, far away from my friends and relations, betrayed by the black velvet band. Her eyes, they shone like the diamond, I thought her the queen of the land, and her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with the black velvet band. Come all ye jolly young fellows, a warning take by me. Whenever you're out on the town, me lads, beware of the pretty calling. You'll fill you up with strong drinks, me said, until you're unable to stand. And a very next thing that you know is, you hindered in on them the plan. Her eyes, they shone like the diamonds, I thought her the queen of the land, and her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with the black velvet band, tied up with the black velvet band.
Yeah, Owen Leonard's gonna do a song for us, then a little song called Blue Ridge Mountain Girl.
It's so cold here in Chicago, the wind can cut you like a knife. Another day, another dollar gone away to spend the night. She was young and I was restless. I set out.
face you make, a pretty bride, as I lay there in the dark. She lays by another side. I've got money in my heart, silver rings that I wear, but I trade them all to spend for the bowl that's in her hand. I can see her standing by the window, and there's nothing sadder in this world than those green eyes of it from crying on my
So Brittany's gonna do a sign for us. Now a little sign called From a Window Up Above. GCOA down below.
Yeah. I've been living a new way of life that I love so. And I can see the clouds are gathering and the storm will break our home.
Jeff, we're going to do a sign for us now called The Beer.
Yeah, I'm going to do this sign for you, skin right on the point.
Well, me and a buddy was sitting around in the Lyre Gunter's bar, and after we down, a couple of beers from the late talking tourists get up and propose the bet. Well, he stood up and he challenged anyone there who would hunt and kill and bring in the beer would win all the beer that he could drink. And when we heard that, we got sick. We had 98 bucks. bucks between us and old beer. We had 8 bucks for food, 90 for beer. So we loaded our guns and ammunition, I like stock barreling. But in the back of the car, a 10-gun year with 3 ball tires and no first gear. In a rusted and busted automobile with a monkey wrench for a steering wheel. And both front doors jammed and rusted permanently shut. Well, that evening we shot some old trespassing signs, some glass insulators for telephone lines, and any number of bots and cans. Let me see, ultimately we knocked off 14 sheep, 2 cows, 6 frogs. We winged 4 hunters and we shot their dogs, but we never even saw a bear, maybe because we was half-crocked. So we started home from our half-baked trip, half-partied, half-blinded, half-cut. In the back of the car, a 10-gun year with 3 ball tires and no first gear. In a rusted, busted automobile with a monkey wrench for a steering wheel. And both front doors jammed and rusted permanently shut. So we started on the highway with all this drinking. And boy, this time we were completely stinking. And I just didn't see the hairy horn which bounded in front of our wheels. But I honked and I steered and I pumped and I veered. But I couldn't help it, it wasn't my fault. A no hit and runner, so I came to a halt. And I climbed out the back door uneasy and queasy to see what it was that I'd struck. But a large as life, but did lie there. Stretched out on the road was a full grown bear. We looked at each other, we smiled. We couldn't believe our luck. So we loaded them into the back of the car, hide, hair, and gut. In the back of the car, a 10-gun year with 3 ball tires and no first gear. In a rusted and busted automobile with a monkey wrench for a steering wheel. And both front doors jammed and rusted permanently shut. So on the way home we started a song, and we weren't singing it for very long when I noticed this third bass voice joining in slightly off key. Now we were singing double, but we weren't hearing double. And if to confirm it wasn't a joke, the bear on his stomach come awoke with a snore and a groar and a whistle and a roar like a right full rattling rut. In the back of the car, a 10-gun year with 3 ball tires and no first gear. In a rusted, busted automobile with a monkey wrench for a steering wheel. And open doors jammed and rusted permanently shut. Now here I lie in me hospital bed, and it's not too painful to grudge about me head, but mostly I sit here and listen to me buddy moan in the opposite bed. It's not what you think though. It wasn't the bear that caused all this physical wear and tear. It was the goddamn monkey wrench spun off the drive jab. Oh, he thought we was all dead. Well, as for the bear, he's 3 beds over, and you can hear him swear, just a moaning and groaning and complaining and pain about how he wants to get home, but not in the car, a 10-gun year with 3 ball tires and no first gear. In a rusted and busted automobile with a monkey wrench for a steering wheel. And both front doors jammed and rusted permanently shut.
Yes, Robert will do a song for us now called Let Me Be a Little Kinder. Guitar player. choirs and singers, no field mats. We're going to do a little song called Old Flames.
Downtown tonight, I saw an old friend, someone who I used to take comfort from long before I met you. I saw a spark in your eyes, a forgotten desire. With a word or a touch, Lord, I could have rekindled that fire.
Yeah, I got a few requests to do now. They're all nothing under 45 pages. Only kidding. First of all, we have birthday greetings to Max Strickland, who's pushing 40 on January the 14th. That's from a dirt buddy. And we also got Peter Rimmel, who hit the big 40 on January 26th. Lordy, lordy, look who's 40. Happy birthday, boys. Only next year and I'll be up there. Anniversary greetings to George and Annie here, who will celebrate their 27th wedding anniversary on February the 10th. That's from two sons and four daughters. Anniversary greetings to Frank and Marilyn Lushman, who will celebrate their 20th wedding anniversary on January 27th. That's from the Herrick family. And anniversary greetings to Lloyd and Joyce Skinner, who celebrated their 23rd wedding anniversary on the 23rd of January. That's from Peggy Herrick. And birthday greetings to Daryl Parsons, who celebrated his birthday on January 23rd, from Mom, Dad, Kevin, and Karen, Joanne, and Colton. Birthday greetings to David Ann, who will celebrate his birthday on the 26th of January, from Mom and Dad and family, also from Godshaw Americas. Special requested by Tracy and Nicole. Birthday greetings to Philip Parsons, who will celebrate his birthday on January 27th, from Mom, Dad, Godmother Karen, and Godfather Arnold. Birthday greetings to Ashley Lushman, who celebrated her fifth birthday on the 16th of January, from Mom, Dad, Kim, and Charlene. And we have birthday greetings to Kim Lushman, who celebrated her 20th birthday, from Mom, Dad, Charlene, and Ashley. Birthday greetings to Frank Lushman, who celebrated his birthday excuse me, on January 18th, that's from Marilyn, Kim, Charlene, and Ashley. Anniversary greetings to Frank and Marilyn Lushman, who will celebrate their 20th wedding anniversary on the 27th of January. That's from Kim, Charlene, and Ashley. And birthday greetings to Marriage Mead, celebrated birthday the 26th of January. That's from Kim. Birthday greetings to Stephen Keynes, who celebrated his birthday on 24th of January. That's from Mom, Dad, and Varick. Birthday greetings to Gladys Keynes, who celebrated her birthday on January 24th. That's from a special friend. Birthday greetings to Marie Sand, who celebrated his birthday on the 20th of January. Greetings from Mom, Dad, and three sisters. And we have birthday greetings to Jocelyn Anderson, who will celebrate her birthday on January the 4th. Who celebrated her birthday January the 4th. Greetings from Uncle Bob, Aunt Melly, and family. Special greetings from cousin Selena. Birthday greetings to Bill Clojure, who will be celebrating his birthday on the 8th of February. This from Ann and family. And birthday greetings to Cheryl Miles, who will be celebrating her 9th birthday on the 27th of January. The greetings from Mom, Dad, Jason, and Bradley. And that's also birthday greetings to Cheryl Miles from Joy. Yeah, Jim will do a song for us now called A Picture of Me Without You. Wouldn't be much of a picture, would it?
Imagine a world where no music was playing. Or think of a church with nobody praying. Have you ever looked up at a sky with no moon? And you
take it back a few years. Now a song called Lee Moore's Cat.
Now, old Lee Moore had troubles of his own. He had an old black cat that wouldn't leave home. Tried everything he knew to keep the cat away. He even gave her to the preacher, told her for the day. But the cat came back. The very next day, the cat came back. Thought he was a goner, but the cat came back because he couldn't stay away. The cat had come nailed in the black yard. Someone threw a boot and he threw it off of her. Hit the cat behind the ear and he thought it was a fright. down came a brick and drove her out of sight, but the cat came back. Very next day, the cat came back. Toddy was a goner, but the cat came back, cause he couldn't stay away. So he gave the cat to the man in the balloon, told him to live with the man in the moon. But the balloon had busted, everybody said, send him all the way to pick the man off this. But the cat came back. Very next day, the cat came back. Thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, cause he couldn't stay away. On the telegraph pole, Bertha sitting in a bunch, he saw an even number and he took him for his lunch. He climbed softly up the pole until he reached the top, put his foot on the leg before it tied him in a knot. But the cat came back. Very next day, the cat came back. Thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, cause he couldn't stay away. Now the cat was a Thursday, Todd was Bill, given to a fellow that was going out with. The train went around the corner, but it hit a broken rail, not from the cold or train, just to tell a tale, but the cat came back. Very next day, the cat came back. Thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, but he wouldn't stay away. Now the man on the corner said he killed the cat of sight. He loaded up his gun with melting dynamite. He waited in his garden till the cat came around. Seven little pieces out of man's body found, but the cat came back. The very next day the cat came back. Thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, cause he couldn't stay away.
Yeah! On a letter we'll do a song for it now called Jamaica Lady.
From home.
If you're gonna do a sign for us now, call it Four Walls of Rayford.
Well, these four walls of Rayford, they're closing in on me, doing 3 to 5 hard labor for armed robbery. I had 2 years behind me, but I could not wait the time. Every time I thought about her, well, I'd die some more inside. Head straps on the back, and memories of her. For the only time that I see sunshine was when I'm in the dirt, digging ditches for the chain gang, sleeping in the cold. Oh Lord, please forgive me, but I could not wait no more. And I'm coming home to see you, Jesus. Will it feel so close this time? Please take mercy on a soldier from the way off Georgia line. When they find me, they must kill me. Oh, Jesus, save my soul. I can't go back down to Rayford. I can't take that anymore. Two kids I had to feed. Well, them one of America's heroes, when they shoot me down, won't you fly, oh glory, proudly, and put my medals in the ground. And I'm coming home to see you, Jesus. Well, it feels so close this time. Please take mercy on a soldier from the way of Georgia line. 'Cause when they find me, they must kill me. Oh, Jesus, save my soul. I can't go back down the river. I can't take that anymore. No, I can't go back down the river. I can't take that anymore.
Brittany's going to do a sign for a nun called Coat of Many Colors.
Every piece was small, and I didn't have a coat, and it was way down in the fall. Mama sewed the rags together, sewing every piece with love. She made my coat of many colors that I was so proud of. Last told she told a story from the Bible she had read about a coat of many colors Joseph wore. Perhaps this coat will bring you good luck and happiness.
Yeah, so Robert's gonna do a sign for us now called the Veil of Wheat Lace.
Shall I do it?
Give it a shot. Robert Simmons celebrated his birthday on the 20th of January. Happy birthday, Bob.
Thanks, boys.
Is it happy birthday doing first?
Should have said that before. He said he was going to do the song.
Anyway, we're going to do a little song. Go put another lock on the bar. Bye.
boxes, oh, my old blue jeans. Come on, baby, you can fill my pipe, then go fix my stubber.
We'll get 'em, boy.
Pour me out another pot of tea. And put another log on fire, baby. And come and tell me why you're leaving me. So I'll put another log on the fire. Go get out some bacon and some beans. Go out to the car, lift it up and change the tire. Wash my socks and sew my old blue jeans.
Yeah, so Owen Leonard's gonna do a song for us now called The Skies of Labrador.
I've traveled on the northern stars since the day that I was born. From the Caribbean to New Orleans, I've been in quite the roam. And the beauty I've seen and the places I've been, I thought I'd see no more. Till I saw the lights that shone so bright in the skies of Labrador. Those northern lights that shine so bright when the night.
Manny will do a song for Nell, a song called for Nell in 64.
I wandered in a village town and stood beside a rail. I gaze upon the setting sun, the saint behind a hill. I gaze on it one moment, and the very sight I see. For the sun, it was no larger than when we were sweet 16. Oh, how I long for those bright days to come again. To come again, they'll never, well, for now I'm 64. The little trout swim in the brook, he wander down below. He swam and so the ever, well, that he did so long ago. The little meadow by the brook, it is so fresh. So fresh and green, and so it was when we were sweet 16. Oh, how I long for those bright days to come again once more. To come again, they'll never, well, for now I'm 64. Years and years have passed and gone, on earth we'll meet. But we will meet in heaven above on that eternal shore. And when we meet no more, we'll burn in heaven, we both shall reign. No more we'll think of days gone by when we were sweet 16.
So Jeff's gonna do another song for us now, a song called Free Fall.
She's a good girl.
was our show for tonight. Come to the end of it. Our first show for New Year. Hope you like it. If you don't. Tough. There it is. Anyway, we need to have a little song called You Ask Me. You said, what's the name of that song? Did you ask me?
You asked me to tell you the reason why the tear in my eye never leaves. You asked me if anyone loves me and why in my heart I am grieved. But if you will listen, I'll tell you of a story in days that are gone, when life was as gay as the flower, when kissed by the sunbeams of dawn. Of one self-beautiful maiden, as true as the blue skies above, each night as we wandered together, the moon seemed to shine on our love. We vowed to be true to each other, that nothing would tear us apart. But little we knew that the future held nothing but a sad broken heart. Then came the day that we parted. We quarreled like young lovers do, and I learned what it meant to be jealous when she told me my love was untrue. She told me her love had been faithful. She told me her love would not die. And then when I wouldn't believe her, she kissed me and bid me goodbye. And then when I falsely accused her, I went back to make her my bride. But there in the door stood her mother, who told me my sweetheart had died. I went and knelt down beside her, alone in the dark, silent room, and prayed that my maker would take me and send my soul down to his doom. So now I have told you the reason. There's always a tear in my eye. There are long years I have waited, just longing to lay down and die. But I wonder if I'll be forgiven when I face the great maker someday. And I wonder if I'll meet my darling on the beautiful shores far away. And I wonder if I'll meet my darling on the beautiful shores far away. Oh,